Alrighty then, I guess we'll start up a game. I haven't played in a while. So, I'm going to play on Sherwood. I've been on day 5, so I've been playing a bit. I wanted to put the little cheat that I found on here. Been running almost everything manual, with the exception of using GPS mod. I just got compost going. Been using the Seed Masters. Let's see here. I've got a head of him going. Park this trailer. Like I said, I've been using the Seamasters. I've got quite a bit in storage. Trailer over here I've got for fertilizer to fill up the Seamaster. Yes, I got the Blanc. Let's see, what else do I got? Got this hydra bed. I added the repair script to it so it'll repair anything. That looks like my looks like that's full, so I need to do something with that. Pretty sure that one was full too. I don't like this in-game one at all. It's too small. It has no capacity. I put a floodlight over here so I can see it. There's my skinny bale picker upper rig. Let's see what I've already harvested this one and I've done part of it in picked up part of it in bales, so I need to finish picking up all those bales. I have that to do. Let's see, what else do I got going on? Yeah, see, there's the compost machine finally making compost. That's my diesel trailer. I just picked up these packet class cloths, whatever you call them, tractors. This is the biggest of the ones in the pack, I think. I don't know if the 950 was in there or not. This is the 850. This is just my tractor I keep over in this compost area. So I want to keep track of this. I want to start working on the compost. Let's see. Fertilizer guy. See what everything was full. Oh, he's almost full. This is a high capacity. It's got it holds 250,000 liters and it's got the really wide header on it, which the header sucks because it doesn't have the animation across the whole thing, but it worked. Really, really wide swath. So I need to, let's see, where's he at? This guy right here. I'm gonna get him out there. Don't know where he is. This is also a high capacity overloader cart that holds 200,000. I was using it for a different purpose a ways back, so it only holds 200, so it doesn't empty the entire combine, but that's fine. I have been running everything manually, but I spent up time this morning. Decided I had a bunch of stuff to do, so I went ahead and let the combine do its own thing under auto wash. Alright, so we'll get him unloading. Let's see, what else did I have going on? This big trailer. This is one of those Aussie trailers that holds 950,000 liters. I did not modify that one. That one came that way. I don't know if anybody's seen this guy yet. I saw it on somebody else's video. He's got tracks on it, and then you hit caps lock and it turns into a helicopter. Works pretty good. I park big transport helicopter that you can actually carry stuff in over here. This is one of my placeable silo mods. These are my silage creating placeables. Just put in grass or chaff, makes silage. I got 83,000 in it. And the chaff that's got 700,000 is the total. There is a newer version of this out that if you put 700,000 in, you can only, it'll keep the balance between the two to where you can't put in more than 700,000 total as it's converting it to silage. This version is the older version, and it'll let you do full capacity on both sides, so it'll hold a little bit more. I never wanted the newer version because I liked it having it just the way it is. But with this mod, with this helicopter, if you turn off the helicopter and it crashes, you get damaged really quick. I don't know that I have a repair guy over here anywhere. Can't remember where he is. Oh, I think he's around the corner over here. Works pretty good though. Let's see. We're here on the cow farm. Oops, got out of it. Wrong button. I'm back in here. Oh, wait, it hit damage. I can't use it. Oh, now I can't even switch over to the other guys. Alright, so here's I think I have three of these hydro beds on this map. Got them spread out so I can have them close to different equipment. I don't have to drive all over the whole map trying to repair things. This mod works really good. It's got that, the hydro bed is supposed to be able to pick up round bells. I don't do round bells. I just like the truck. Runs really good. And I decided I really liked it if I added the repair mod to it, so. So there we go. All repaired. Milk truck. Let's see, I was over here. I know the eggs are right here. If I can get to them. There. Eggs. Let's see, what else are we going to do? I do have sheep going. Sheep around the corner over here. Let's see. Alright, so here is Mr. Grasshopper. I did try to put the repair mod on here, but this, the way the person built this, it's like it's a dual layer mod where it relies on a second mod to make it run at all, and I couldn't figure out how to get it to add the repair script to it because of that double layer thing. It's really weird. Anybody that does mods would have to look at it. They know what I'm talking about, but see, okay, so this thing's filling up. All I'm gonna do is I've got it turned on and just sit and fill it up. So I don't know if it's the map has the error in it or it's a combo of mods that make it error out like this. I've never had this happen before, but I'm gonna take advantage of it because I'm lazy. There we go, full capacity. Since I got this full, might as well go put some in here. I don't like this thing, but since it's here, I'll use it. This is the second piece of that silo mod that direct connects to the entire farm. This actually fills up faster than the conveyor belts that are over on that area. So I've just been using this. Let's draw, let's get some silage. Let's see, what is that? I really love this disc ripper. It's really cool. It's got a real, it's pretty wide. Is it 16 meters? And the way it folds up is really cool. It doesn't take up too much space when it's closed. So you can get it through the gates on this map. They're kind of small. This mod from, I've had this thing forever, the Steyr 6600. I think there's a single wheel version of this too. Let's see. And a track version. I like using the dual wheel version. This is that tractor I was using to pull the water around. Love this thing. Just got this yesterday and it is useless. It does that whole wheel shake thing and just sits and moves around the whole time. I'm going to have to yank it out next time I reboot. Yeah, it did come with a 9500. Or 950 rather, 850. I got a 620. And here's the big buds that I just got. 320 version and the 747 version. So I'm gonna save the game. How much were they? I got enough money. This is the 747. This is the big one. I think the fertilizer tanks work, but I'm not positive. can remember what my last mod was. That one. There we go. So you need smaller Big Bud. Evidently, some of them were in production, and the smaller Big Bud one was the gargantuan 747 one, which I think it was D-Rad something or another Productions or something took this mod and actually scaled it up a little bit to make it bigger. So it's actually bigger than most of the other articulates like it's supposed to be. And like I said, I don't know if the fertilizer tank works or not, but oh, that's the little one. Nah, that was the big one. Oh, it's got UI control. I guess I could use this one on this map, and it's got the dynamic smoke on it. It's not as big as I thought it was on this one. So if I wanted to, I could use it on this map. The other one's just a bit big for this map. I didn't think it'd fit in the gates. And it's got the guy that fixed it, added the hood shake and all that. That's kind of cool. Again, dynamic smoke on it looks a lot better. Looks pretty good. I like the hood shake on it. Anyway, I don't know what else I want to show. That'll be about all I want to do on this video. I didn't set a timer to see how long I was going. So, that'll be it. Have a good one. Talk to you next time. This is the second piece of that silo mod that direct connects to the entire farm. This actually fills up faster than the conveyor belts that are over on that area. So I've just been using this. Let's draw, let's get some silage. Let's see, what is that doing? I really love this disc ripper. It's really cool. It's got a real, it's pretty wide. Is it 16 meters? And the way it folds up is really cool. It doesn't take up too much space when it's closed. So you can get it through the gates on this map. They're kind of small. I don't remember where I got this mod from. I've had this thing forever, the Steyr 6600. I think there's a single wheel version of this too. Let's see. And a track version. I like using the dual wheel version. This is that tractor I was using to pull the water around. Love this thing. Just got this yesterday and it is useless. It does that whole wheel shake thing and just sits and moves around all the whole time. I'm gonna have to yank it out next time I reboot. Yeah, it did come with a 9500. Or 950 rather, 850. Yeah, 620. Here's the big buds that I just got, 320 version and the 747 version. So I'm gonna save the game. Oops. How much were they? I got enough money. This is a 747. This is the big one. I think the fertilizer tanks work, but I'm not positive. Remember what my last mod was? That one. There we go. So you need smaller Big Bud. Evidently some of them were in production, and the smaller Big Bud one was the gargantuan 747 one, which I think it was D-Rad something or another productions or something took this mod and actually scaled it up a little bit to make it bigger, so it's actually bigger than most of the other articulates like it's supposed to be. And like I said, I don't know if the fertilizer tank works or not, but oh, that's the little one. Nah, that was the big one. Oh, it's got UI control. I guess I could use this one on this map, and it's got the dynamic smoke on it. It's not as big as I thought it was on this one. So if I wanted to, I could use it on this map. The other one's just a bit big for this map. I don't even think it'd fit in the gates. And it's got the guy that fixed it, added the hood shake and all that. That's kind of cool. Again, dynamic smoke on it looks a lot better. Looks pretty good. I like the hood shake on it. Anyway, I don't know what else I want to show. That'll be about all I want to do on this video. I didn't set a timer to see how long I was going. So, that'll be it. Have a good one. Talk to you next time. This is the second piece of that silo mod that direct connects to the entire farm. This actually fills up faster than the conveyor belts that are over on that area. So I've just been using this. Straws, get some silage. Let's see, what was that? I really love this disc ripper. It's really cool. It's got a real, it's pretty wide. Is it 16 meters? the way it folds up is really cool. It doesn't take up too much space when it's closed. So you can get it to the gates on this map. They're kind of small. I don't remember where I got this mod from. I've had this thing forever. The Steyr 6600. I think there's a single wheel version of this too. Let's see. And a track version. I like using the dual wheel version. This is that trick that I was using to pull the water around. Love this thing. Just got this yesterday and it is useless. It does that whole wheel shake thing and just sits and moves around the whole time. So I'm going to have to yank it out next time I reboot. Yeah, it did come with a 9500. Or 950 rather, 850. I got a 620. And here's the big buds that I just got. 320 version and the 747 version. So I'm gonna save the game. How much were they? I got enough money. This is a 747. This is the big one. I think the fertilizer tanks work, but I'm not positive. Remember what my last mod was? That one. There we go. So you need smaller Big Bud. Evidently, some of them were in production, and the smaller Big Bud one was the gargantuan 747 one, which I think it was D-Rad something or another Productions or something. Took this mod and actually scaled it up a little bit to make it bigger. So it's actually bigger than most of the other articulates like it's supposed to be. And like I said, I don't know if the fertilizer tank works or not, but oh, that's a little one. Nah, that was the big one. Oh, it's got UI control. I guess I could use this one on this map, and it's got the dynamic smoke on it. It's not as big as I thought it was on this one. So if I wanted to, I could use it on this map. The other one's just a bit big for this map. I don't even think it'd fit in the gates. And it's got the guy that fixed it, added the hood shake and all that. That's kind of cool. Again, dynamic smoke on it looks a lot better. Looks pretty good. I like the hood shake on it. Anyway, I don't know what else I want to show. Probably about all I want to do on this video. I didn't set a timer to see how long I was going. So, that'll be it. Have a good one. Talk to you next time. This is the second piece of that silo mod. Direct connects to the entire farm. This actually fills up faster than the conveyor belts that are over on that area. So I've just been using this. Straws, get some silage. Let's see, what was that? I really love this disc ripper. It's really cool. It's got a real, it's pretty wide. Because it's 16 meters. And the way it folds up is really cool. It doesn't take up too much space when it's closed. So you get it to the gates on this map. They're kind of small. I don't remember where I got this mod from. I've had this thing forever, the Steyr 6600. I think there's a single wheel version of this too. Let's see. And a track version. I like using the dual wheel version. This is that tractor I was using to pull the water around. Love this thing. Just got this yesterday and it is useless. It does that whole wheel shake thing and just sits and moves around the whole time. I'm going to have to yank it out next time I reboot. Yeah, it did come with a 9500. Or 950 rather, 850. I got a 620. And here's the big buds that I just got. 320 version and the 747 version. So I'm gonna save the game. How much were they? I got enough money. This is a 747. This is the big one. I think the fertilizer tank.